Hey guys, so I know a lot of you are in this situation. You bought an iPhone X a year ago, a year flew by, honestly faster than I could have imagined, and the new iPhones are here, the iPhone XS and the XS Max. Now the question is, do you upgrade? This thing still feels new, it feels great, but the new one is just a little bit shinier, it's got that new gold color. What else is different? I'm gonna break it down in this video, and there are so many differences actually between the X and XS. Of course, I'm gonna try and make it as easy as possible for you to understand whether or not you should upgrade or not, and I think I'll have some very valid points here. So let's go ahead and break it down. How does the XS or XS Max differ from the X, and is that difference worth upgrading to this year, or should you skip it? And there are a lot of small stuff, there are some bigger things, but it's mostly those little differences, quality of life upgrades between the X and XS, mostly like going from the iPhone 6 to 6S, but it seems like even less of a difference now, but I'll still try and lay it out for you. Before I begin, I wanted to mention that I will be mostly comparing the iPhone XS to the iPhone X. The XS Max is very similar aside from the size, but if you guys wanted to learn more about the differences between those, I'll leave a link down below in the description. So let's start with materials. The iPhone XS now has a more durable glass. Apple says it's the most durable ever, so if you're likely to break your iPhone by dropping it, the XS would certainly be a great upgrade. You know what else would be a great upgrade here? A case or a screen protector. If you have one of those, usually you're pretty covered, but if you do happen to break the back glass on an iPhone X, you basically have to pay $400 and replace the entire thing. So yeah, a more durable phone certainly would help here. The durability extends into water resistance as well. The new iPhone XS gains an IP68 water resistance at 2 meters versus the iPhone X's at 1 meter. And most of the time it does fail. I've had so many friends actually lose their iPhone 8, 10 series just by dropping it into a little bit of water. It's very strange how it works. Sometimes you can go really deep on it, like on my channel. Sometimes it just happens to break. So if you're likely to go around water, and by the way, Apple was advertising it like, yeah, you can go into the ocean, you can go into the water. It's not covered by warranty, but you could do it now. You know, it's 6.5 feet for 30 minutes. So that's a very, very good rating. If you want to be around the water without a case, the iPhone XS is certainly the one to get just for that. And that's actually a very, very big deal. It overshadows Samsung's rating at 1.5 meters, which is 5 feet. And of course, with the iPhone XS, you get that stunning new gold color. If you're tired of the silver or space gray and you wanted to try out what Apple calls it, their most stunning color ever, you certainly can get that with the new iPhone XS. And something that bothers me more than it should, the asymmetrical ports on the iPhone XS. So do consider, you're going to be looking at that every single time you go to charge, unless you're a wireless charger. You're going to see a different amount of speaker grills on either sides of both the XS and the XS Max. It honestly doesn't matter at all, I just thought I'd mention it. Oh, and prepare to get a little bit stronger, as the iPhone XS now weighs an additional 3 grams. So if you wanted a lighter load, certainly the iPhone X. And I'm kidding, by the way. Now the displays on paper look exactly the same. The specs are the same, Super Retina. But Apple says that they improved the display even more on the XS series by increasing the dynamic range by 60%. So colors should look even better in your content and games and whatnot over the iPhone X. But don't let that fool you. This display is great. I doubt you're even gonna notice that difference. I'll certainly try to see it, but this is an amazing display. Organic LED, it's super bright, it's everything you need. So displays alone, there's almost no difference. And something I think that will compound to make your experience so much better is a faster Face ID on the XS. Apple says that they improved and made the secure enclave even faster and more secure. So you're gonna be able to get into your phone even faster. So the XS is technically going to be a time saver. Time is money, right? And probably the biggest reason to upgrade, aside from the larger display size, for me personally, is the Apple A12 chip. This thing is an absolute monster. It's the industry's first 7-nanometer chip in a smartphone. Huawei is not far behind Apple on that end, but 7 nanometers is gonna be future-proofed for years to come. Apple is still supporting the iPhone 5S 5 or 6 years later now, and the iPhone XS should last roughly between 4 to 5 years, possibly even 6, who knows. S models get some extraordinary support by Apple. That doesn't mean the iPhone X will get dropped. It still has an incredible processor, but the 7-nanometer A12 will last even longer. And if you wanted to buy the iPhone XS and actually keep it instead of watching next year's video, iPhone XS versus iPhone 11, should you upgrade, then it certainly will be very future-proofed. The biggest difference with the A12 that I think you'll notice on a daily is that Apple says app launch launching will be 30% faster thanks to a 15% increase in speed on the high-end cores and 40% efficiency increase in the low-end cores. The GPU is also 50% faster. It's now a quad-core GPU versus a 3-core on the iPhone X, which for gaming you'll certainly notice, especially with that larger screen size of the iPhone XS Max. And the iPhone XS has 4 GB of RAM now instead of 3, so your apps should stay open in the background longer, which means you'll have to do less reloading and again save more time. So if time is very valuable to you, seems like the XS will save plenty. And the camera of the iPhone XS receives some substantial upgrades, mostly because of the A12 and the image signal processor together. There's a new mode called Smart HDR, very similar to what Google offers right now, where it combines multiple exposures, multiple dynamic ranges into one photo and gives you the perfect shot every single time. Apple did say that there's zero shutter lag now, so you could even take pictures a little bit faster with no delay whatsoever. Shooting towards the sun is even better, the dynamic range, just because of that new feature. It combines a bunch of photos together and will give you a greater dynamic range here. What most people don't know about the iPhone XS camera that is very substantial is that the actual pixel sizes on the sensor have grown to 1.4 micrometers versus 1.22. This means better low light performance as well as better colors, just because it's able to accept more light. And Apple did say that video in particular does better in low light thanks to those increased pixel sizes and the Apple A12 chip. And now stereo recording via video is available thanks to the 4-microphone setup of the iPhone XS. Of course, there's that selectable focus mode where you can take a picture and then change the focus in the background afterwards by adjusting the aperture, and that wasn't possible before the A12 apparently. But if you get some apps from the App Store, it's certainly possible on the iPhone X right now, so that alone should not be a reason to upgrade. And the selfie camera actually supports 60 frames per second in 1080p now, whereas the X only did 30, and the selfie camera can do that adjustable bokeh thing as well. The iPhone XS receives an upgrade in the speakers as well. They said it's a wider stereo sound, so things are more booming. It's gonna be a better sound in general, in gaming and movies. And storage. Apple adds an additional storage tier to the iPhone XS. If some of you filled up that 256 and needed more, the XS does offer a 512 GB upgrade, and supposedly with that, it also gets 8 GB of RAM to control all of that memory. I can't confirm that to be true just yet though. The price of that though is $1,349, $1,449 on the XS Max though, so prepare those very deep pockets. If you guys have T-Mobile, the iPhone XS is actually a very big upgrade because it supports a new band, the 71 band, so you'll get even better LTE performance all across America. The iPhone XS does have a gigabit LTE, so faster LTE speeds will be supported for download and upload, and its roaming support is unparalleled. Apple says it's the best right now, better than any iPhone before it, and of course it does have that dual SIM capability. It's eSIM here in America in most areas except China, as there it's a physical dual SIM, but you can still get two numbers on one phone. And actually at the keynote, I noticed that there's a dual signal bar, which actually looked really cool, very efficient use of that, so you could get that potentially too. And battery life. So the iPhone X usually can get me through an entire day. Sometimes I'll have to charge twice if I'm really using it, but don't expect that to change much with the XS. Yes, the battery life will be 30 minutes better, but 30 minutes is not a lot of time. You'd be better off just getting a battery case or a portable battery charger or something. So battery life is better, and I've heard also a rumor that there's a potential that it's included with a 10-watt fast charger that just hasn't been enabled yet. Like Apple did with the iPhone X, they could push out a software update that could enable a 10-watt fast charging. Right now it's limited to 7.5. So maybe a faster charger is available, but not in the box certainly. You will not be getting a fast charger in the box, still that 5-watt adapter, and no headphone dongle, just so you know, in the box either. The iPhone X does have one, so you have to dish out an additional $7 or $9, however much that is, to get that. And that's most of the physical changes. Let's just talk about theoretically upgrading. So for your iPhone X, this thing still has an incredible resale value. You can sell it right now, as a company says, for $680. Okay, let's say $600 to $680. So for $400, $300 to $400, you can upgrade your iPhone X to a XS. Question is, do you do it? Do you spend that extra $300 and get all of those little physical changes here and there, faster, more future-proofed processor, and a slightly better video camera, slightly better battery life at 30 minutes, a new gold color if you want it. I personally would not do that. Honestly, this phone is amazing. It did not just suddenly get slow just because the new one came out. It's still gonna be very, very nice. iOS 13 should bring out a lot of features in it, possibly some new functionality. Honestly, Apple hasn't done much with the OLED at all. And I'm hoping with iOS 13 that they do bring a always on display, maybe a dark mode if they really want to please us. The only way I see someone upgrading from an iPhone 10 to a 10S is if you're going for the Max version. That's a night and day difference in terms of usability. It's gonna be a huge upgrade. But from the 10 to the 10S, unless you really, really like that screen size and don't mind spending the money, I just don't see that upgrade being justified. But if you're going from a 10 to a 10S Max, that's certainly a very big upgrade. So sell this thing, get your money out of it, and put it towards a larger 10S Max that's gonna be very, very future-proofed. Now, I wanna give you an example as to why I'm upgrading from an iPhone 10 to a 10S Max. Money not being an object, it's mostly just because of that screen size and the faster time-saving thing. So Apple says apps will launch 30% faster. The camera has zero shutter lag. You know, it has an additional gigabyte of RAM. It just seems like overall it's going to be a time saver if you use your phone a lot. And I'm all for saving time and being more efficient in certain areas. So it feels like that $300, $400 additional price will certainly pay itself back compounded over time. And I know that may be a ridiculous reason to upgrade, but 30% is quite a lot and it will add up. Oh, and hey, you'll be getting some new wallpapers on the iPhone XS by default in settings. So that'll be nice until Apple takes them away in a year or so, as they always do for whatever reason. But anyways, guys, there it is. I honestly would not recommend upgrading. Your iPhone X is still amazing. It still feels new, I'm sure, from a year ago. When Apple reduces that notch, that will be a much more compelling upgrade. But for now, unless you're going to the XS Max, it's simply not worth the money right now. There it is, guys, the iPhone XS versus the iPhone 10. I say certainly keep your 10 for another year and see what Apple's got up their sleeves, unless you're going to the XS Max and really, really want it. Let me know your thoughts down below. Will you be upgrading or not, and why? Hope I made this choice a little bit easier, guys. Peace.